Everyone is talking about management, but we hardly know what management is. The term has become so generic that we have forgotten the essence of it. So today we will understand that what the basic meaning of management. It is basically an art of getting work done through and with others. Means the role of a manager is not only to instruct the subordinates about the work, but also to help them in completing that work. So it is an art of getting work done through and with others. Now if we talk about the basic nature of management, or you can say the features of management, so one, you can say it is goal oriented because every manager has certain objective in mind for which he assigns work to subordinates. So this means it is goal oriented. Second, a manager integrates different resources. Your resources may be financial resources, human resources, then your promotional tools. So all these are integrated for effective management. Then next is, it is a continuous process. Many a times it is assumed that management is only applicable wherein decision making comes, but no, it is a continuous process, which means it is applicable at every single step. Next point is, it is all pervasive. Means it is present all the time and applicable to every situation. Then it is a group activity. Everyone has to work in coordination with each other. The subordinate has to understand the need of the supervisor, and the supervisor has to give or assign work depending on the capabilities of the subordinate. So it is a group activity. Then an important aspect is decision making. Management is responsible for taking all small and big decisions in an organization. Then it is multidisciplinary, as we did. It includes all phases, be it human resource, financial, marketing, operation, research. So it is basically a multidisciplinary area. And last is, it is dynamic. Means it keeps on changing with changes in economy, nature of clients and everything. So the basic nature of management can be summarized through these points. Now, after getting an idea of the meaning as well as nature of management, let's understand what is the scope of management. Scope of anything is the boundary till which the particular concept is applicable. So scope can be further categorized into four main heads, which are your main departments. One is production management. Then is your marketing management. Financial management. And personal management. An easier way to remember these points is to take them as four departments of any organization. Now, when we talk of production management, what all comes is the product design. This decision has to be taken by this department. Then your location of the plant where production process will take place. Then control of operations means managing and controlling how things are getting done. So control of operations. Repairs means in case any repair is needed, this has to be brought to the notice of production manager. And finally, quality control. Production manager is responsible for ensuring that the products that are being produced are fit with the quality requirements of the management and the client. Second is your marketing management. Marketing, as it is very clear from the term itself, it includes research for needs. Means this, it is important first to know what the customer want and then go to the production step. Then is your planning. Next is your selection channel. Means which channel you would be using for promoting your products. And last is a promotional act. Means once the goods are produced, you need to promote the same in front of the target audience, which is handled by the marketing management. Then coming to financial management. Firstly, to identify fund sources. Means from which sources an organization can raise money. Then is ensure proper utilization of funds. Once the funds are received, it is the task of financial management to see that whether they are being utilized properly. Then next is your administration of earnings. This again is the responsibility of financial management. Coming to personal management, it is also known as your human resource management. It involves your recruitment, means calling employees, calling people to apply for the job, then finally selecting, then you need to train them, then you need to promote them, and finally their compensation. So all this makes the scope of management very clear, which can be categorized into production, marketing, finance and human resource. After understanding the scope of management, let's specifically understand the functions of a manager. Means what all functions a manager needs to perform as a part of his duty as well as responsibility. The very first function is of planning. Planning is simply deciding in advance what, when and how things are to be done. So in this case, you have not yet started with the implementation. You are only deciding in advance that how the process will continue. So this again is the task of a manager. Second is your organizing. As the name is making it very clear, organizing means your organization of, first of all, team who will do the task, and secondly, the resources that they will be using for successful accomplishment of the objectives. Third is your staffing. It is a human resource function which includes your recruitment, followed by selection, followed by training. Then your fourth managerial function is leading. Now the function of a manager does not stop on providing training to the employees. He needs to be a good leader, and this can be done by giving motivation to the employees. So it includes motivation and guiding. This is a very important function of any manager. And the very last function is controlling. Once you are done with all your duties, you need to check whether the employees are doing their work properly or not. So controlling, in which you will give feedback. So these are broadly five main functions of a manager. Now, one aspect of management on which a debate goes on from time to time, and it is that whether management is an art or a science. As we all know, art is something that requires skills, maybe your birth skills, some skills that one is having from the time of birth. And science is something that works on facts and experiments. So some people claim that management is just an art, some say that it is just a science. But actually it is a combination of both. This means management is both an art and a science. So let's understand how. The reason for calling management an art is that it requires some practical knowledge, secondly creativity, because a manager has to deal with different types of employees, so he needs to act differently with everyone. This demands creativity. Then is perfection through practice. Everybody can't just be a good manager for everyone. So this perfection comes through practice, which proves that it is an art. And lastly, it is goal oriented. Means behind every move of a manager, there is some set goal in his mind, may it be a short term goal or a long term goal. Coming to management as a science, why we call it as a science? Because it involves experiments. It checks cause and effect relationship. And lastly, the test of validity, in order to see whether a method that you are adopting is valid for the target audience. So this brings us to a conclusion that management is neither solely art or science, but it is a combination of the two. Now, a very important aspect of management that is recently in trend, it is your ethics in management. One is ethical when he has ability to differ between right and wrong. When someone is good enough to identify that this act is right and this act is wrong, the person is called to be ethical. So, when talking about ethics in management, we can again classify them into three types. One is your immoral management. Second one is your amoral management. And third is your moral management. Immoral management is one which lacks ethics, lacks principles, they only think of making money. Think of money. This was your immoral. Talking about amoral, this is basically a negligence stage. Yeah, you can say negligence management, which is neither immoral nor moral. Means they are simply unaware about ethics. And when you talk about moral management, it is simply the opposite of amoral and immoral management. And they follow ethical principles. So this classification makes it very clear that what an ethical management is, and if a management is not ethical or is negligent, then how can we classify them? Now, one cannot say that our management is unethical or negligence and we can't help it. Yes, there are certain guidelines that should be followed. For an ethical management, these guidelines are: one should always obey the laws. Secondly, always tell the truth, means you should never hide any important information from your employees. Then show respect for people, and lastly, do what you expect. So all these are the guidelines that would ensure an ethical management. This was all about management.